you will be a doctor, a different doctor, and that doctor will be a living medicine treating with the help of modern medicine with the intention of curing the patient. Shiv Yog says that please do not treat the disease but treat the root cause of the disease. That is absolutely important. The doctor has to become a cosmic medicine, and doctor has to activate the inner mechanism within the body of the patient so that he can start producing healthy cells. Please stop saying the disease is incurable. The cure is possible.
If there is a disbalance in kaph, pitta and vata, there is a disease in the body. Then I come to the Tibetan medicine, that is the integrative part of our Shiv Yog. Because Shiv Yog comes from the Saptarishis, and through the Avdhoot parampara, it has been passed on from the guru to the disciple. Then their philosophy is yin and yang. There is a male energy and there is a female energy. If there is a disbalance between male and female energy, if there is a disbalance between yin and yang, there is a disease. But it is very similar to your nadi system of Ayurveda, which is called the Ida and Pingala. Ida is the female energy and the Pingala is the male energy. So when I'm talking about the anatomy and physiology of the human body, I'm talking about this also. Now I come to when I talk the human being as a human being in totality, I'm not looking at only the physical body, because an individual is not the physical body, let me tell you. Now it is proven, scientifically it is proven, that every individual has five bodies, pancha sharira. The physical body, annamaya kosha, according to Vedas, the etheric body, the pranamaya kosha, the astral body, the manomaya kosha, causal body, the Jnanamaya Kosha, and the supercausal body, Anandamaya Kosha. Now why I am mentioning about these five bodies? The reason is that much more powerful than the physical body is the etheric body. Etheric body is more powerful. More powerful. And I will give you an example. When I was very young, I was in a school. In the morning, we used to go for jogging. It's an incident of Delhi. And there was a huge park. And there was a weightlifting center in the middle of that park where the weightlifters, they used to come. And it is all the God's divine wish. The Leela of Shiva, you know, he sends a guru to teach the knowledge and wisdom. It was the holidays time. Holiday had just begun. 2 months holidays. I went to the park and I saw 95 or 100-year-old yogi. Very old man. White beard, white hair. And he had two very heavy mudgar. Mudgar is the wooden objects were there. And as if he was waiting for me, he was just that those were there and he was standing. And the moment I went there, he just lifted and started moving. As if it is very light object. I became very curious. And I started looking at him, what is he doing? And then he kept it, very softly he kept it on the ground. And he smiled at me, as if he is talking to me in the language of silence. I don't know what he was, but he was really exciting me. I was feeling very happy. So I went to him, I said, can I also lift? He smiled, he said, try. When I tried to lift, I found as if it is already dug in the ground. Then I tried to move one single mudgar, even that I could not move. I remember I climbed on it. I was young at that time. I climbed on it. And while I was conversing with the great yogi, a best weightlifter of that weightlifting center, these days the gyms are there. Earlier it used to be akhada, where the mud was there, the people used to wrestle, and there was a table and so much weights. Either people will stand and they lift, or they will lie on a bench and lift. And I used to admire that young man. He used to lift so much of weight. He came tall, with all muscles, excellent. And he came, he asked me, what is happening? So I said, bhaiya, lift the mudgar. I wanted to show the yogi, where I come, we have strong people. And believe me, he tried both. He could not even lift. There was so much of strain. And then he lifted one up to this much and his whole body was trembling. And I told him, move it backward. When he tried to lift further, it fell down. And when it fell down, then that young man did not stay there. He hurriedly went off. He moved. And I was alone again with the yogi. Very quietly he lifted the mudgar, kept it there. I was curious. I looked at him. I inspected him. How much muscles does he have? Because that young man had so much of muscles, the arm was also huge. I looked at him and I found there is no muscle. Very thin, very fragile old man. I asked him, how is it possible? He has so much of muscles and he could lift the weight and you have no muscle. Aapne kaise utha liya? He smiled. He said, see, he was trying to lift the weight with the power of his body. But do you know who runs this body? It is the prana which runs the body. And prana is more powerful than the physical body, much more powerful. And that makes sense. If the prana is flowing in my arm, I can lift. And if by any chance I cut off the supply of prana, my hand will be like this. I cannot lift. So it is the prana which is lifting my body, the flow of etheric energy, so it is more powerful. So if I know how to enter into my etheric body, I am more powerful. And then etheric body, the pranamay kosha is much more powerful than the physical body. And the third body is astral body, the manomay kosha. The manomay kosha is much more powerful than the etheric body. Then is the jnanamay kosha, the causal body. The causal body is much more powerful than the astral body. And the supercausal body is much more powerful than the causal body. And it was the great opportunity for me. I stayed with that yogi for quite some time, and very lovingly he taught to me about the sukshma shariras and how to master it, how to master. And believe me, this is what I had demonstrated in Rishikesh in one of the shivir, that when I taught the younger youth that enter into your pranamay kosha, then they could lift, the four children, they could lift 250 kg weight easily with one hand above their this thing. But then I wanted to do much more than that, because the Anjaneya, the Hanumanji, how he could lift the whole mountain. I thought of demonstrating that I make them lift the very huge jo shila patthar hota hai. But then the fear was that if they, by chance, they come into their physical body, they will not have weight, so it might cause the accident. Now, when I am talking about the anatomy and physiology of the body, in the pretext of Shiv Yog, then we say that the disease never come in the physical body at the first instance. Please remember that. 3 months or 6 months in advance, the disease comes in the etheric body, the pranamay kosha. It remains there for 3 months or 6 months. You might have observed in your medical practice that somebody comes and say, I am getting shooting pain in my heart. And when you send the patient for the test, you find everything is all right. Or they are reporting some other problem and you find it is all right. But after 3 months or 6 months, the patient comes to you and you send him for the test and you find that he has a heart problem or he has a physical disease anywhere else. So it is the signals which the etheric body was passing on to the physical body. It might have been observed, many people come and they, that I'm having pain and I go for test, nothing comes. Is an indication that the disease has already come in the etheric body and it might take 3 to 6 months to enter into the physical body. So how a doctor, we can make a doctor medicine, how we can make a doctor cure the disease? It might be incurable at the physical level. Even if we really understand the human body in totality, it is possible to cure the body at the physical level. And if we have an understanding of etheric body, learn the etheric body, because it takes quite some time to learn the higher bodies. The initially I will only cover is the etheric body. Even that is a vast, vast, vast subject. Because the organ which you have in the physical body, the same organ is there in the etheric body. You cannot look inside, you cannot touch inside the organ, but if you master the Shiv Yog, you can touch the organ at the etheric level. And even by touching the organ at the etheric level, you can find out whether there is a disease in the organ or whether there is no disease in the organ. Now, when you ask me about the anatomy and physiology and the principles of Shiv Yog, how you can heal. Now, as an individual, I say, I don't look at the individual as a single individual. Now, I would talk in terms of medical science. Every individual is a community of 50 trillion cells. Am I right or wrong? How many cells are there? More than 50 trillions. This is, if somebody says 50 trillions, we'll have to agree because we cannot count. If somebody says 40 trillions, we'll have to agree. If somebody says 60 trillions, we'll have to agree. But they are in trillions. So every individual is not an individual, it's a community of 50 trillion cells. So if, as a doctor, I must have the understanding of the cellular behavior, in Shiv Yog, this is what I am going to teach you. Because I am not going to restrict at the cellular behavior. Because I asked a question that after few weeks, every cell, it dies. Am I right or wrong? And a new cell is born. After a few weeks, the old cell will die. The living period of every cell is a couple of weeks. If I say the organ heart, then within 5 or 6 weeks, every cell of the heart will disintegrate. And the new cells are going to take birth. Yes or no? As a matter of fact, a human body, the total human body, after within 8 months, every old cell is going to die. And within 8-9 months, the absolute new human body, even the brain cells, the new cells are going to come. Yes or no? Now my question is, suppose anybody has a problem in the liver, some damage is there in the liver, or somebody has a problem in the kidneys are shrinking or damage is there, or there is a blockage in the heart. Now why is it God has given the opportunity, God is saying that I will replace the old cells and I will give you new cells. But why is it when the new cell is taking birth, it is exactly at that micro millimeter level a diseased cell is taking birth? Why not a healthy cell? And the answer is, that the cells, we call it the genetic engineer or engineering or genetic behavior, the genes. We very commonly say that the disease is a genetic disease. I am going to prove it. It is not genetic. I am going to prove it. It is not genetic. We'll have to go much deeper. In Shiv Yog, we'll have to have the understanding of much deeper level of this. Now the cell, it has nucleus. And the nucleus has DNA and protein. Am I right or wrong? Now it is the latest finding. They say that the DNA is the blueprint of the cell, and the protein. Earlier we were understanding that it is the DNA which is giving life to the protein to create a structure. But it has been observed the DNA is not giving, the stem cell studies which have been made, it is not the DNA is giving life, DNA is only the blueprint. Blueprint of any building is not the architect, is not the builder, it is just a blueprint. And they observed that there are certain electrical impulses, or they are signals which are coming to the cellular nucleus, which is giving life to the protein to create a structure so that the new cells are born. Now they found that these signals, if there is a cell which is a disease cell, then they try to find out why it is diseased. So they found one reason could be a physical injury. If a physical injury is there, the signal can disturb. The second factor they say is the presence of toxins in the body. If the presence of toxins are there in the body, they disturb the flow of signals, and a disturbed signal is going to reach to the cellular nucleus, and the cell is going to, you know, there'll be problem. But after detoxifying a person, after they find that there is no physical injury, still there is a signal coming, and that signal is responsible for the protein structure and the cell, whether it is determining whether it is a new cell is going to take birth or it is going to be a disease cell. That means the human being, the Shiv Yog says, this is the statement I am going to make. When the patient comes to you, he is a flow of energy. He is a flow of energy. The Einstein, he discovered, because the Vedic, I will not like to mention a shlok and then translate, because now I am addressing the medical profession. So I am trying to translate our Vedic wisdom in your medical language. I don't know how good I will be in translating. Now, the Einstein say E is equal to mc square, that formula. And that formula says that every physical matter is made up of energy. And that we have agreed now. Because the physical matter is the atom. Physical matter is the cell. But when I disintegrate, I find electron, proton, neutron, they are not solid particle, but they are energy. So that is the energy which decides the birth of the atom, and it is some energy which decides what is the electronic, the atomic configuration has to be made, and that decide what is the matter, then is the matter. The physical matter, any physical matter, my body is a physical matter. So when I understand, my understanding of the physical body is, that's what we say, the first stage of Shiv Yoga is sthula sharira, I must convert into yoga sharira. The yoga sharira, like the energy which is moving helter skelter, I must learn to gather the energy, and I must ensure the proper flow of energy. Like the sunlight, the sun rays which are coming, if I keep a piece of paper under the sunlight, for many days I can keep, nothing will happen. And if I use the convex lens and direct the focus, the cellular energy, the sun energy, the solar energy, focus it on the paper, within few seconds it will catch fire. Yes or no? So the scattered energy, I am a physical body and I am made up of energy. There is an electron, proton, neutron. They give birth to the atom. The atom gives birth to the cell. Cell gives birth to the tissue. The tissue gives birth to the organ. Organ gives birth to the system. The system gives birth to the human body. So from the physical matter, I enter into energy. So this is what I am. Now why the yoga? Yoga is the merging, is the unification. The yoga sharira means I must channel my energy. And imagine if a doctor can channel his energy, the energy with so much of knowledge, with so much of education, with so much of understanding of the subject of a disease and that organ, if his energy is scattered, what result he is going to achieve? But if he achieve a yoga sharira, that means he direct and channel his energy in a particular direction, then he is successful.
पहले मैं खर्चा करता था, एक एक कर पे 8 से 10 हज़ार खर्चा होता था। अब बाबा जी से प्रेरणा मिली, वो संजीवनी शक्ति जब खेत में डाला तो मुझे एक एक कर में 12 क्विंटल सोयाबीन का उत्पादन हुआ। शिव पद्धति से जब मैंने यूज किया तो मेरा उत्पाद बढ़ गया, माल की क्वालिटी अच्छी बढ़ गई और ये जो खर्चा लगता था वो कम हो गया। फसल की क्वालिटी हरी रहती है अच्छी और जमीन भी ऐसी भुसभुसी नरम रहती है, यानी रासायनिक खाद डालने से जमीन की पोत खराब हो जाती, कड़क बन जाती है, तो इससे ये मुलायम रहती है। मेरी गाय 6 महीने ही दूध देती थी, तो मैंने गाय पर प्रयोग किया, संजीवनी शक्ति डाली तो 1 साल भर गाय दूध देने लगी। वो 6 महीने देती थी, वो 1 साल भर देने लगी। परिवार में सुख शांति रही और खेती में भी उत्पाद हो रहा, खर्चा कम लग रहा, सुख शांति है परिवार में सब बाबा जी की कृपा से।
साधना भी हो जाएगी, तुम्हारा ध्यान भी हो जाएगा, तुम भी स्वस्थ होने शुरू हो जाओगे। तुम्हारे मन में जितने तनाव हैं उनसे भी तुम मुक्त होना शुरू हो जाओगे। शिव योग कृषि का पालन करना शुरू कर दिया तो भंडार भर जाएंगे, खुशहाली आ जाएगी। वो भोजन जो खाओगे वो अमृत तुल्य भोजन होगा।
शिव योग अद्वैत श्री विद्या साधना ब्रह्मांड की वो सर्वोच्च साधना है जो न केवल सभी के ध्यान और साधना का सार अपने भीतर समाहित करती है। मानव बोध गुरु अवधूत शिवानंद जी इस ज्ञान की धरोहर के पथ प्रदर्शक हैं।
जो भोग और मोक्ष दोनों दिलाए वो है अद्वैत श्री विद्या साधना।
भोग और मोक्ष को देने वाली इस शक्ति साधना में ब्रह्मांड के सभी रहस्य छुपे हुए हैं।
इस साधना में इतनी शक्ति है कि जो भी किसी भी भाव से दीक्षा लेने आएगा उसकी नेगेटिविटी दूर हो जाएगी और वो सुपात्र बन ही जाएगा।
आपके जीवन में धन, प्रचुरता, खुशहाली, सफलता, भक्ति भाव से इस साधना को करने पर मनुष्य के जन्म जन्मांतर के संचित कर्म भस्म होते हैं। शिव योग अद्वैत श्री विद्या साधना में साधक शक्ति पात लेता है और वो मोक्ष की यात्रा का सुपात्र होना प्रारंभ हो जाता है।
श्री विद्या की साधना करता है, कुछ समय के बाद उसको संकल्प सिद्धि प्राप्त होती है।
शिव योग अद्वैत श्री विद्या साधना मनुष्य को लोक परलोक से पार लगाने की साधना है।